guys, welcome. It's Tori. Thank you so much for clicking. Today we're going to be doing this look. We're going to be doing a get ready with me with a bit of chit chat and dancing. I kind of just let it all hang out today. It's Friday! Woo! So let's get into the video. Alright you guys, so today I wanted to do just like a chit chat, get ready with me. I don't really have anything planned, but I need to have a video film for Friday, so we're just gonna chill and chit chat, listen to a little bit of girl, this is my girl playlist, and this is like my Christina Aguilera burlesque, Mariah Carey. So nothing's really gonna change today. I'm gonna wear a different lipstick today. So we're starting with this Master Prime Green. I was thinking about for a product reviews I could get, because I have noticed that those palettes with like the green and red and purple that you're supposed to put under your foundation to help with like redness and the circles under your eye and stuff like that. And so I was thinking about giving that a try. And filming a video on it for you guys. Just let me know what you think of that idea. I always really like to make sure my primer is dry before I throw on foundation. And I am gonna be using this foundation again. This is the one that I reviewed. And I liked it. I feel like for 9 hours, I know that it was kind of wearing down on my chin right now. Oh, that reminds me. Okay. So I am testing out a new face wash for a different review. It's one I got off of Amazon. Girl, my face hasn't been this clear. I know that it looks like a lot of spots fucking everywhere, but those are a lot of scars. But this is the only one that I've got that's raised right now, and it's not even raised. My face is smooth. Other than that, I could be throwing on like BB cream, but I don't have any. So what is your best and favorite BB cream? Because okay, so foundation. Oh, I need this. Gonna make sure that is dry. I'm actually gonna go ahead and throw them brows on. Alright, there's only so much you can do for the eyebrows, so. Alright. So today I wanted to not use my cream contour palette. We're gonna dip into my little Wet n Wild. Oh. Just kidding. You gotta finish all the creams before you put powders on. Every time I hear a Fergie song, I think of my older sister and my older brothers, because they were always called Fergie in high school because their last name was Ferguson. and I always was so jealous because they could make their last name into a cute name like that, and I was stuck with Whited. I can do it, that is White. I was already there, okay? Just kidding, you know, to all my fellow Whiteds. I'm not a Whited anymore, but you know, I feel your pain. Okay, so now we're gonna do the contour, and instead of contour, I'm just gonna use bronzer, and I'm gonna go throw it back to my OG contour brush. I know that I should be using a smaller one. This brush has just been through the ringer. I don't even think that that was the shape that it was in when I got it. I think that it went like this, but it might have. Maybe it was just thinner like this, but you know, it's an OG brush. And it's so powdery, so this is what it looks like. And this is a really good powder. I think that this product is only like $3. Now watch. Ugh, that was not what I was hoping for. But look, you can just see it. And we're just gonna very carefully this is my natural color. Okay. So, for my nose, because you can't forget your nose. Got to have your nose done. This is how pigmented the cream palette is. This is my brush that I use for the cream, and it still has stuff on it. Can we get that J-Lo contour? I'm priming my eyes with my OG Milani. I've been using this forever, and I swear, I know that I need to try something new, you know, get out there. But I'm just like, why? You find something that works, and this literally, I just bought this, and the only reason I bought a new one was because I forgot all of my makeup at my mom's house, or at my house when I went to my mom's for Christmas, and my eye makeup will stay on for forever. You saw it in my the foundation review that was posted on Wednesday. I really like what the powder on the eye does for me, for my eyeshadow. In my opinion, it just looks so pretty. So I normally don't do right here, but I just want to see what it looks like. To just do it around the mouth. And then bake at 350 degrees for 15 minutes. Just kidding. God, do you see what I look like? It's just the powder, I swear. This is gonna be beautiful. Okay. The sun kills me because it will not let you see. Oh, you see how dirty that palette is? This is the OG palette, you guys. I love this palette. I'm so obsessed with this palette. If you don't already have the Jaclyn Hill palette, what are you doing with your life?
Just kidding. If you don't have the palette, you'll get there, okay?
You know, I'm gonna start from somewhere. Got my handy dandy white rag on my foundation, my Milani foundation and flower matte lipstick review. I did this eye look and I was just obsessed with it. It was just like a brown gold and it was just really pretty. I did it with my Jaclyn Hill palette, so we're gonna recreate it. So we're gonna start with Silk Cream, which to me is my favorite. I like Silk Cream and MFEO for transition shades. I just think that they're really pretty and I like to do that all over my shade, all over my lid. You even want to bring it up to this. So we just use Silk Cream, which is this one right here, and then we're gonna go in. I was just digging the fuck out of that color. Okay, so next we're gonna go in, and we're gonna mix Creamsicle, which is this very pretty mustard yellow, and then we're gonna mix Pudder, which is this one right here. We're gonna mix those and throw them on there. We're using the same brush. In with Pukey, which is this one. Pukey. And this will be the last color I use with this brush, and then we're just gonna slap it everywhere. We want it to be all over it. We are gonna go in . So these are the next two brushes that I like to use, and I'll usually go to this one, which is like a dome, and then to this one, which is a bit tighter, but I'm gonna start with this one and then we're gonna use this one to buff it out. So we're gonna go in. All right, so we're gonna dump it. We're going to jump in to Central Park, which is this really like brown. It's just brown. It's a dark brown. And this one, we're gonna try really hard and we're just gonna keep it really into that crease. Down right here, just because we are going to be doing a wing. So I know I said I was going to use that dome brush to blend, but I just prefer this one for blending. I'm not gonna put any more color on this really tight brush, but I'm gonna go in. We just want to brighten that up a little bit. All right, and then we're going to go. Just want a little bit more brown. We're just going to blend because we don't want any harsh lines. Alright, so we're gonna start on that cut crease. Now we've done our cut using sharp shape tape. We're gonna go in with this gold. This gold is so beautiful. It is so creamy. It's so pigmented. I always use my finger. Just look at that. And then we're just gonna slide it. And this color is called Queen. Yes, hunty. And then we're going to apply a highlighter, which is always High Beam. Oh, it's not even called High Beam, it's just called Beam, but I've been calling it High Beam. Oops. I think that my eyes are done. I'm just gonna pop on some liner. We are working with that wing again. So for the waterline, we're using that NYX white. Using that Maybelline. Fingers crossed, that looks good. All right, so that is done. Now, we gotta finished that contour. I swear this is the longest. I've already been filming for 44 minutes, y'all. To try something a little different, I've been watching Jaclyn Hill, and if you also watch Jaclyn Hill, you probably know that she started putting her highlighter on with her beauty blender, so I just wanted to try it. Oh, let's take all that powder off my face. Let's see if we have more of a color payoff from my little. Okay, so I'm seeing. I just love this highlighter. I just like this. In my personal opinion, I like the way it looks with just chapstick on your skin. I mean, on your lips. Because to me, you can just keep applying the chapstick and, you know, you don't have to worry about the drying and the